Mandarin is super hard to learn. As a matter of fact, it takes you more than 1,000 hours until you're actually good at it. So I wonder what would happen if I, as a simple European guy, tried to learn Mandarin for 10 days straight, 1 hour a day. This video is sponsored by Mandarin Blueprint, so big thanks to them for providing me their entire course, which will help me acquire as many skills as possible within 10 days. Alright, what do we have here? Everything you need to know to develop incredible Mandarin Chinese pronunciation packed into one video course. Let's just get straight to it.
So what you see in front of you here is in fact the entire Chinese language. There are only 409 simple syllables in Chinese. All of the 409 different spellings actually are made up of at least two, usually three, of the following components. So initials, basically the beginning of the word, the finals, the ending of the word, and a last but very important part, tones. Let's talk about first tone first. So we call this one the singing tone. And it's essentially the highest point in your vocal range. The way I would say the English word may be, maybe. So just try it with me. This is the word for mother or mum. Ma.
Ma. So I already know how to say mother.
Second tone goes from your midpoint, basically your normal speaking voice level, all the way up to first tone level, your highest point in your vocal range. The way you would maybe say, are you going? Or just simply, huh? It should sound like this. Ma?
Ma?
So the one that's taught most commonly, the big down up one, would sound something like this. Ma? This is the one that's taught most commonly as the third tone.
Ma?
So that is the word for horse in Chinese.
Oh my lord, that's the word for horse. So basically the word for horse and mother is the exact same one, just the tone makes the difference between the meanings. Oh my lord.
Another pronunciation that's great to learn is he, she, and it, which are all exactly the same pronunciation.
Oh, all right.
Pa.
The verb to be afraid of. Pa.
Pa.
And now that we have a verb, we can make a simple sentence in Chinese. He's afraid of it. How would you think we would say that?
Pa. Pa. Ta. Ta pa ta.
For simple yes or no questions, we can just add on a ma on the end of any statement.
Oh, okay.
Ta pa ta ma.
Ta pa ta ma.
He's hungry in Chinese. You could actually just say ta e. But the more common way to say it is actually to add something else on the end. A l.
Ta e le.
How would you ask the question, is he hungry?
Ta e le ma.
Oh, okay. So he's hungry is ta e. But is he hungry means ta e le ma.
So this is thirsty. Cool. So how would you say she's thirsty?
Oh my god. Okay, so that would be ta.
Ta ke le.
Oh my god. Why le?
Now to contrast, here is cola in Chinese. So this would be ke le. Cola is ke le. And thirsty is ke le.
Oh my lord. What a complex language. Ta. Ta ulama kulu kulu ta pa ta.
How would you say I'm hungry? Wa ula. Now, after you said I'm hungry, you might also say ni na. It means what about.
Okay, so there is no is, right? To be, basically.
And bu is for negation. So you basically want to say no or not this thing. You just put bu in front of it. So you've got a cat and you want to ask it, are you thirsty? 你渴了吗? I'm not thirsty, I'm hungry. How would it say that?
So it will be 不渴了?
我不渴.
Oh my lord. This is a lot to take in. 我不渴 and 我饿了.
So if you want to say I'm going, you would literally just say I go. 我去. Now if you want to say I'm going to drink cola, I go drink cola. Go ahead. 我去. And how would you ask the question, are you going?
你去吗?
你去吗?
How would you say no? Remembering what we learned before.
不去喝.
我不去.
Oh, I have to add the 我. The intonation makes 50% of the entire language. So even if you get every single word right, if you don't pronounce it correctly, you just can't speak Mandarin.
Basically in Chinese, it's used to link two nouns together. So for example, 我是 Luke, I am Luke.
So you don't even decline them, right? So it's just I be whatever.
Love in Chinese. So all you gotta do is just add a fourth tone to I and you get I. How we put it in a simple sentence, remember? Simple sentences in Chinese, pretty much the same grammar as English sentences. So how would you say, I love you?
我爱你. Got it.
我爱你. Now, judging by the look of this guy's face, he's not...
我不爱你.
我不爱你. So how would you ask, do you love me?
你, 你爱不爱我?
你爱不爱我?
Nice.
To eat a meal in Chinese, you would say... 吃饭. It actually means the word rice as well, which kind of makes sense if you understand Chinese food culture. Chinese people don't really consider a meal without rice.
我知道，我不知道，你渴了吗？我爱你，我不爱你，你爱不爱我？哪里？这里。妈妈在哪里？你住在哪里？ Oh man.
帮means to help in Chinese. So if you were this baby, for example, and you wanted to say, help me, how would you say that?
帮我,
帮我.
Huh, knew it.
Take a verb and you just add 在 in front of it and it would change, for example, from to help to helping. He is helping him.
他在帮他,
他在帮他,
他在喝茶,
他在吃饭. To confirm yes.
嗯means yes. This is amazing.
Hey, correct. It's also just a way of, if someone say calls your name, right? It's just saying, yes, I'm listening.
Okay, so there are three different ways of saying yes. Is this what you're telling me? So in one case, you're repeating the most important word of the question. In the second case, you have the and in the third case, you have this. Mandarin can be so confusing.
Where are you from? Or literally in Chinese, you are where person. 你是哪里人?
Okay, the most important question that I usually ask. Where are you from? 你是哪里人? 帮我他在帮他他在喝车他在吃饭他们很笨笨吃什么这里好热好热你是哪里人
To introduce yourself in Chinese, all you have to do is say 我叫 and then add your name afterwards.
我
So for example, for me, I would say 我叫 Luke. You can also say 我是 which is literally I am.
Oh, okay, okay. So 我叫 is I am called, like I call myself, and 我是 is I am.
To have in Chinese. 有. Now, how would you say not have or don't have in Chinese?
不有.
It's actually not 不有, 没有. Why it's 没 and not 不, don't worry about it. This is the sort of questions, if they pop up in your head, like, but why though? Knowing why it's 没 as opposed to 不will not make you better at Chinese. It will just mean that you know a fact that not many people know. Now, how would you describe this guy here and say, he is smoking?
So it would be 他在抽烟抽烟
他在抽烟
Ah, I managed with a bit of help with looking back, but I managed.
And you're going to be using it all the time, and you probably hear it every day if you come to China, which is goodbye.
再见,
which is literally again, see.
再见 is goodbye. That's cool.
Essentially not that common, but it's still something you have to have in your arsenal. And that word is 您. And it's essentially the polite version of the word you. So if you were talking to someone with higher social status than you, instead of saying 你好, you say 您好. And you'll make a great impression if you do that.
Oh, okay. 你好 is hello. And 您好 is also hello, but to someone you respect.
去看电影.
This is literally go see movie. Now, if we wanted to ask the relatively long question of do you want to go to the movies today? This is how we would ask it.
你今天要不要?
你今天要不要去看电影? I hope, oh man.
Another great phrase for 用 to use would be 不用, which would literally translate to no use, but it's more akin to the meaning of no need, which is exactly the phrase that a beautiful young Chinese girl said to me on the subway once when I asked for her phone number in front of about 30 people. She just looked up with a smile and said, 不用谢谢, which was probably the most polite and most painful way I've been rejected in my life.
Damn. 我是 Peter. 你有 чима? 没有, 我也没有, 你有没有 手机? Oh my god, this is so tough. 我也有, 您好, 谢谢您, 银钱, 明钱, 他没有钱, 他很有钱.
Here are the numbers 1 to 10.
Whoa, 1 to 10, that's cool. Okay.
一,
一,
二,
二,
三,
三,
四,
四,
五,
五,
六,
六,
七,
七,
八,
八,
九,
九,
十,
十.
The numbers work like simple mathematics. For example, to say the number 11, you just say the number 10 and then number 1. So 10 plus 1. 十一. The 30 is 3 times 10. So you would say 310. 三十. If you want to go a bit bigger, you want to say the number 78, you just say first the multiples of 10, so 7 times 10, and then plus 8, so 7, 10, 8. 七十八. So we know how to say how many, at least for small numbers, which would apply to months.
Okay.
几月. So July is the 7th month. So in Chinese, you just say 7 month. 七月.
七月.
December?
Oh.
12 month. 十二月.
Oh, so you just add always a 月. Okay. It's the last day, so let's go through the entire material one last time and just see how much I actually know. Taman Vishimizai Chifan Ta Vishimizai Hu Kulu Yinve Ta Kulu Wo Aini Wo Ye Aini Wo Ye Shu Nizai Jama Yo. I hope. Niyo Jama Wo Ye Meyo Nin Hao Sheshe Nin. Alright, 10 straight days of studying Mandarin are over. Here are my thoughts. Number one, as I've said it many times already, intonation makes all the difference. So I can clearly tell that I've never encountered a language which is so hard to learn just because intonation is so important. Number two, it was a fun journey. Don't get me wrong, those 10 days were quite some fun. But because the language is so hard, I have mad respect for anyone who's even remotely close to mastering Chinese. Number three, there are a few areas where Chinese is actually easier than most European languages, like take locations for example. At, in, on, and whatever is the same thing in Chinese, or to be does never change. Also, the numbers are straightforward, so it's easier to learn them as well, but in most cases I will definitely say that Chinese is a way more complicated language than most European ones. And number four, a proper course is absolutely essential if you want to learn Chinese. Like, take Spanish for example, right? It's such an easy language, you don't really need an online course, you don't need a course in general, because you can just use online resources, right? But when it comes to Mandarin, you need people to teach you what is important, what to watch out for, that the intonation makes all the difference, and yada yada yada, right? So it's super important to have a proper course. And if you want to learn Mandarin as well, or at least try to learn it, then check out the first link in the description box below and start your free trial today. And if you know for sure that you want to learn Mandarin, then use the code LINGUALIZER20OFF to save 20% on any package. A big thank you to Mandarin Blueprint for creating such an amazing course, and I wish you guys a happy studying.